Brothers and sisters in Christ, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. We have met this day to learn more about our faith as an assembly and as an ecclesia of God. We are sharing or reflecting on the name that we have built so much confidence in, the name that we have attached ourselves so strongly to, and the name that we have used as a weapon in many encounters and many endeavors of our life. Today's teaching is on the theme, the name Jesus. If I am not exaggerating, the name Jesus is the commonest of all names. A name known by many of different religion, race, gender, and people of different stages of life, be it children or adults. The name Jesus has been featured in different songs, movies, and has been found on the lips of people who have not even attained the age of reasoning. After hearing of him when he was 12 years old in the temple, which can be conferred from Luke chapter 2 verse 42 to 47, nothing was heard about him again until he attained the age of 30 when he was baptized by John. However, his encounter with the elders in the temple gave a hint of who he would become. A young boy of that age answering questions of trained and educated Jewish rabbis and asking them questions they couldn't answer. Picturing the scene alone brings about the kind of spectacle that occasion was. The only problem is that this young, talented boy got lost from the scene. He raised himself for 18 good years and nothing was heard about him after his public encounter like it happened in the temple. He was seen as a genius, a superman, but now he raised himself from that class and lived a normal life like any other normal child. People even thought he probably couldn't maintain the talent and that he probably killed his talent before it could sprout. He lost the edge of maintaining what could have become one of the greatest talents on the planet. Beloved, just when people had erased him from memory, there came this man after 18 good years. No longer a boy, but now a man. He appeared to be baptized by John the Baptist. You can confer this from Matthew chapter 3, verses 13 to 17. Although as a forerunner, John had talked about him. Nobody knew who he was and where he was hiding. However, during the baptism, another sign came up, indicating and proving the 12-year-old boy never lost it, and that this time, he is extraordinary better. Now addressed as a beloved son, accompanied by a cosmic sign. You can check this from Luke chapter 3, verses 21 to 23. This chapter or this particular account of Luke indicates that Jesus began his ministry after the baptism at the age of 30. From that time, this young man called Jesus was to change everything. He attracted followers than any rabbi in the history of the Jews, and he became a thorn in the flesh to many a religious leader, a blessing to the poor and afflicted. Wherever he went, miracles followed. He changed the system. Men and women spoke about him. Children talked about him. The old sought to see him before they die. In our current computer age, his name would have been on every WhatsApp page with his pictures on Instagram and on the television stations. Not to report of his death, but to report of a new celebrity who is unknown as in where he originated from, but has taken the country by storm, not only in his hometown and region, but far and wide. From that era down to our own epoch, his name Jesus is associated with so many things and is interpreted in so many ways. It is interpreted as a healer, as a provider, as a father, as a friend, as a miracle worker, as a leader, as a warrior, and as a king. In his connection to animals, he is at one point a lamb, and at another time he is addressed as a lion. In tracing his origin of birth, they say his parents are Mary and Joseph. At another time, they say he is of no earthly father and that Joseph was the foster father, and that his father is in heaven, God the Father, who is the head of the triune God. Mentioning the name Jesus brings about miracles and other great happenings. How can one name mean so much? How can one name be associated with a lot and connote a lot? If it was to be just a word, we would say it is one of the words which brings a lot of confusion. Is the name Jesus a confused name? Is it a mystery? Does it contain some sort of power? Beloved, the name Jesus. What does that name mean? What power does the name Jesus carry? Is it just the name or the person bearing the name which makes it so powerful? Is the name a weapon to believers? If it is, who can wield such a weapon? So we begin addressing the first question. What is the meaning of the name Jesus? In the Gospel of Matthew chapter 1 verse 21, the angel Gabriel was sent to a young virgin called Mary. And upon reaching there, the angel informed Mary that she shall bear a son and name him Jesus, for he will save his people. The first indication the name Jesus gives is salvation. The name Jesus is the English form of the Greek Yesus, which is a translation of the Hebrew Yehoshua, or in simple terms, Yeshua. This Yeshua comes from the Hebrew root signifying Jehovah is salvation. This name Jesus we are talking about is very significant and powerful because of whom it represents, a man and a God. God our Savior, Christ who is Emmanuel, God with us. You can confer this from Matthew chapter 1 verse 22 to 23. Now let us seek to address the second question. How powerful is the name? Meaning we are looking at the efficacy of the name Jesus. In his letter to the church in Philippi, that is Philippians chapter 2 verses 5 to 11, Paul gives a detailed explanation that although the name was given before the birth of this young man, its efficacy comes as an exaltation from the Father after the Son displayed humility through humiliation on the cross. From the humiliation came the exaltation, a powerful name Jesus, a name above every name, a name every knee bows to when it is mentioned. So we mention the name Jesus when we pray, because it is a weapon. We wield it like a warrior rolls a shield. According to Philippians, the name Jesus works in our favor. That is why Paul will address Timothy in 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 12 that he knows whom he has believed and that he is sure that he is able to guard until that day what he has been entrusted with. Beloved, the name Jesus was a common name used during the time of Jesus, and it is still being used by many. So the power and efficacy is not just in the name, but it is more in the bearer of the name, the person who is Jesus the Christ, Jesus the Anointed. So Yeshua the Christ, more like the Anointed Savior. Brothers and sisters, we now go to the third and last question. Who can wield this name Jesus? Having known the meaning of the name Jesus and realizing it can serve as a weapon for believers, we now ask ourselves, who can wield the name Jesus if you want to use it in warfare? Who can the name Jesus work for? We base our reflection on Acts of the Apostles chapter 19 verses 1 to 12. Bible records that Paul did great things and wonders in the name of Jesus at Ephesus. Bible says he performed miracles in the name, such that even handkerchiefs and aprons that came into contact with him were used to heal the sick. Paul was wielding the name Jesus as a weapon and extracting its power thereof. Paul had entered into a communion with the person of Jesus, and he has invested into that relationship with years of prayer, discipline, and living a life holy and acceptable as a man in relationship with Jesus. The interesting part of this scripture text comes in the verses 13 to 17, where some itinerant Jewish exorcists undertook to pronounce the name Jesus over those with evil spirits as Paul did. This group was qualified by two unique titles. One, they were itinerant, meaning they were people who have traveled from place to place and that they have amassed years of experience in their field. Secondly, they were exorcists. Those of us who are not Catholic, an exorcist is one believed to be able to cast out demons or perform the raiding of demons or other supernatural beings who are alleged to have possessed a person or something. However, the outcome wasn't the same as that of Paul. The verse 16 says, the evil spirit overpowered them and inflicted wounds on them. Beloved, how could this be? The same name Jesus Paul used to cast out demons, the same name Jesus, people pronounce it, they declare it, and yet the demons overpower them. Which name have they been using all along when performing exorcism? The Spirit asked two important questions. He first made a statement that Jesus we know. Why? Because he is the Savior. Paul we know also as a faithful soldier who wields the name Jesus well and worthily. As for you guys, your name doesn't register in the book of the generals of God. You are not even registered as a foot soldier. So the question is, who are you? But verse 17 records that fear fell on the inhabitant of Ephesus, and then the name of the Lord Jesus was restored. Beloved, the name Jesus. Is it powerful? Is it efficacious? Can it be used as a weapon? Yes, it can, but not by everyone. Not anybody at all can wield the name Jesus as a weapon. Only those who have prepared themselves and have overcome the pain factor to invest into their relationship with God. Only those can wield the name. That is, those who are declared as the generals of God and not those who are foot soldiers. Beloved, what do we mean when we are talking about the pain factor? The pain factor is when we have been able to overcome all the pain. Many of us, when we are asked to pray, we complain. Spending just 20 minutes in prayer, we complain. Many of us, we eat every food we come across. We gallop everything that comes our way. Many of us, we spend our time gossiping. And when a brother or a sister wakes us up through a phone call to pray, I don't complain. Whatever that has to do with investing into a relationship with God, we complain. We complain we are tired. We complain of headache. We complain it is too much. When it comes to fasting, it is too much. When it comes to prayer, it is too much. When it comes to waking up at dawn, it is too much. When it comes to retreating to hide ourselves in the mountains to pray, it is too much. When it comes to sharing the word of God, it is too much. When it comes to studying at dawn the scriptures, it is too much. When it comes to spending just 15 minutes with our quiet time in the morning, it is too much. Everything is painful for us. But when it is coming to partying, we are okay. When it comes to eating and drinking, we are okay. Beloved, only those who have managed to overcome the pain factor can wield the name Jesus. Do you pray often? Can you abstain from food just for a while? Or you gallop everything? Can you let go of the pleasures of the world? Can you undergo pain and discomfort in order to invest into your relationship with the Lord? Many of us use the name Jesus to pray. And we try to use it to break, but we get no results, even when we stay hours in prayer. Beloved, how many of us have been asking the question? Whenever I watch people on the television performing great miracles,
Whenever I watch great men of God, generals of God, apostles of God, using the name to cast out demons, I am intrigued. I am energized. I rise up and then I jump into it to seize the opportunity to do the same. I pray, I fast, I will the name Jesus, yet I hear no result. Things are not going well in my life. I use the same name Jesus that people use it to cast out demons, yet the result is the same. I see no sign. However, some declare it in just a second and the results flow. Beloved, the name Jesus is a weapon and it can be wielded by a Christian, but only by those who have undergone the same factor, only by those who have come to bear the name generals of God. I encourage you this day to invest into your relationship with the Lord. Progress from being a full soldier to become a general and wield the name Jesus readily in order to harvest its power. Once again, beloved, the name Jesus. I encourage you, keep on investing into your relationship with the Lord. The power that comes with the name Jesus is not just because of the bearer of the name. Because to tell you the truth, even the player of Manchester City, Jesus, bears the name Jesus. I've studied with friends in theology who bear the name Jesus. Many bear the name Jesus at the time of Jesus. But it was only Jesus Christ of Nazareth who commanded such a power with the name, because the Father exalted him. So all we are trying to say is that the power that comes with the name Jesus is not necessarily just because of the name, but the one who bears it, who is Jesus Christ of Nazareth, our Savior. I encourage you this day to invest into your relationship with the person of Jesus, and you will be able to harness the power that comes with the name Jesus. Have a spirit-filled day, favored of Yahweh.